Welcome dear students in today's lecture of chemistry. And the topic of today's discussion is polymer, and in that polymer, the compounding of plastic. The compounding of plastic, it is nothing but there are different ingredients are added during polymerization process which impart some special properties to the final product. So that is compounding of plastic, and this is my today's presentation. Compounding of plastic, so it is nothing but to impart certain definite property to finished plastic product. The plastic is compounded with other ingredients. So compounding of plastic, it is nothing but to impart certain property, special properties to the polymeric material are called as compounding of plastic. And for that purpose, a certain ingredients are present, that ingredients are added. So these ingredients either discharge a useful function during molding or impart some useful property to the finished product. So compounding of plastic, it is nothing but to impart certain properties or special characters to the polymeric material by adding some ingredients. So these ingredients are, the first one, it is binder. So binder, the main purpose of that binder to binds other constituents of the plastic together, or to hold other constituents of the plastic. The main purpose of that binder is to hold other constituents of the plastic together. Also, on the basis of binders used, it determines which type of treatments are needed, which type of molding techniques or fabrication methods are required to the articles from the plastic material. So binders, main role is to bind all the constituents which are used during the processing of a polymer material. And second is, which type of treatments are required for the final products. And nearly 30 to 100% binders composed to the plastic. 30 to 100% binders are composed to the plastic. For example, natural or synthetic resins or cellulose derivatives, cellulose nitrates or cellulose acetates are used as a binder. The next, filler. So filler plays an important role in a compounding of plastic. So these roles, first, it reduces shrinkage on setting and brittleness, reduce the cost of plastic material, impart better tensile strength, hardness to the plastic material, opacity, finish and workability. So it imparts better tensile strength, hardness to the plastic material, opacity, finish and workability, and imparts special characteristic to the finished product. Special characteristic, for example, barium salt. So barium salt are added as a filler in compounding of plastic, which make whatever the products are obtained, it impervious to the X-rays. So in X-ray field, whatever the plastics are used, so in that, barium salts are added as a filler. Asbestos, another example, asbestos, it provides corrosion and heat resistance property to the plastic material. Asbestos provides corrosion and heat resistance property to the plastic material. Another way, carborundum quartz mica provides hardness. In a geology, the term is present, that is hardness. And in that, the maximum hardness are observed for that material, that is carborundum. Nearly 9 to 10 hardness are observed for that material. And this carborundum or quartz or mica provides extra hardness to the plastic material. Carbon black. So this carbon black increases tensile strength of a plastic material. Tensile strength. Then shredded textiles increases impact tensile strength. So such type of different purposes of addition of fillers are observed in a compounding of plastic. And there are some examples are given which are used as a filler, that is cotton, corn husk, graphite, clay, paper pulp, wood floor, humus, then some metal oxide, that is zinc oxide or lead oxide, and some metal powders, that is iron, copper, lead, aluminium. So these are some examples of fillers are present which are added in a compounding of plastic. So that is filler. Then next, plasticizer. So plasticizer, main role of that plasticizer is improve plasticity and flexibility of a plastic material so as to reduce the temperature and pressure required for molding. Also, it plays an important role in determining the properties of finished product. So which type of products are obtained? Addition of plasticizers are totally depends on that product. The next plasticizing property are believed due to mainly to the partial neutralization of intermolecular force of attraction. In the resin molecules, and they impart great freedom of movement between polymeric macromolecules of the resin. At the same time, it reduces strength and decreases chemical resistance property of the plastic material. So that is plasticizer. And commonly used plasticizer, that is different types of oils are present. The first one, vegetable oil, then camphor, then salts of higher fatty acid, that is esters of higher fatty acid, that is oleic acid, stearic acid, palmitic acid, then tributyl phosphate, triphenyl phosphate, triacetin. So these are the examples of plasticizers are present, which are added during the compounding of plastic. Then next, dyes or pigments. The main role of addition of a dyes or pigment imparts special color. So whatever the plastic materials are used, it becomes an attractive. And for that purpose, a specific color dyes or pigments are added to provide decorative color to the plastic materials. The main coloring materials are organic dyestuffs and opaque inorganic pigments. So these are the catalogs. These are the colors. Different colors are present as per the requirement or whatever the products are obtained. It becomes an attractive. So for that purpose, an attractive coloring agents are added in a compounding of plastic. Some examples are given. So in that, in first column, coloring agents are given, and in second column, imparting color. So first one, ultramarine, it imparts blue color to the plastic material. Carbon black, it imparts black color. Calcium carbonate, zinc oxide, they imparts white color to the plastic material. Chromium trioxide, it imparts green color to the plastic material. Ferric oxide, red color. And antimony sulfide, it imparts crimson red color to the plastic material. So in that way, whatever the products are obtained, they become an attractive by addition of dyes or pigments. Then next, lubricants. So lubricant, it is a material which avoid wear and tear of a metals or machine parts. But basically, in a compounding of plastic, the lubricants are added to provide good finishing to the plastic material. Also, in addition to that, improving flow characteristics and friction reduction in the processing of machine, the lubricants are added. For example, different oils are present, wax are present, stearates, oleates or soaps are present. They are added as a lubricant in a compounding of plastic. Then catalyst. So catalyst, it is a substance which alters the rate of chemical reaction. So basically, in a polymerization, there are different types of catalysts are added. So during molding process, that is compounding of plastic or fabrication technique, the catalysts are added in case of thermosetting plastic to accelerate the polymerization process of fusible resin into cross-linked infusible resin. And basically there are different examples are given. Hydrogen peroxide, that is H2O2, benzoyl peroxide or acetyl peroxide, they are used as a catalyst along with ammonia and its salt, or sometimes metals like silver, copper, lead, they are added as a catalyst. Some metal oxides are present, that is zinc oxide or acetyl sulfuric acid. So these are used as a catalyst in a molding process or fabrication technique. And last one, the stabilizer. So basically, whatever the plastic materials are available in a market, they are used under a variable condition.
And for that purpose, it is essential to add a stabilizer. The main role of that stabilizer is to prevent their degradation, to prevent the degradation of a plastic material that is final product of a molding process. Also to improve thermal stability during the processing. And for that purpose, stabilizers are used. And there are examples of stabilizers are given. Lead salt, like white lead, lead chromate, red lead, serve as an opaque molding compound. Then stearates of lead, cadmium or barium are transparent molding compounds. So these are the some examples of stabilizers are given which are added in a compounding of plastic. So that is all about compounding of plastic.